Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, I will discuss choosing and using the right storage option for optimal application performance. AWS has many storage offerings, each meeting different needs for your workloads. I'll help you demystify the offerings through patterns you can use to leverage the right storage services. Let's say you're a global enterprise running various applications. You likely have many different kinds of storage requirements for different workloads. One of your applications might be a public-facing website. You can use Amazon Simple Storage Service, or S3, to host the static assets of the website, like images and videos. Because Amazon S3 is an object store that offers industry-leading scalability, availability, and security, you can store and retrieve any amount of data from anywhere. You should use Amazon S3 for read-heavy workloads requiring object storage, such as content distribution, web hosting, big data analytics, and ML workflows. It is well suited for scenarios where data needs to be stored and accessed via an API and distributed globally over the internet. Amazon S3 is highly scalable, and you do not need to worry about provisioning storage or expanding storage for S3, and you will only pay for the amount of storage you are currently using. Another enterprise application may require Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud or EC2 that run your core workloads. This workload could be batch processed or an ERP system that requires high throughput and low latency. To support EC2, you need Elastic Block Store or EBS. As the name indicates, EBS is an easy-to-use, high-performance block storage service for both throughput and transaction-intensive workloads at scale. Block storage offers high-performance, durable storage that is direct attached to an instance to meet these workload requirements. EBS volumes can behave like raw, unformatted block devices backed by disks of different types. Keep in mind, though, that unlike S3, an EBS drive can only be attached to one entity at a time. So if your workloads run in a cluster like big data or machine learning workloads and have such a requirement for shared storage, then EFS or FSX will be better suited. In the case of Amazon FSX, it is designed to provide an easy and cost-effective way to launch, run, and scale feature-rich, high-performance file systems in the cloud. It supports a range of workloads. With FSX, you can choose between four widely used file systems: Lustre, NetApp ONTAP, OpenZFS, and Windows File Server. This choice is typically based on your familiarity with a given file system or on matching the file system's feature sets, performance profiles, and data management capabilities to the requirements of your workloads. Be sure to select one that closely matches your requirements. In the use cases previously mentioned, let's say you do not know the amount of storage that would be required or the usage profile. In those cases, Amazon Elastic File System or Amazon EFS provides serverless, fully elastic file storage so that you can share file data without provisioning or managing storage, capacity, and performance. Amazon EFS is built to scale on demand to petabytes without disrupting applications, growing and shrinking automatically as you add and remove files. You can use EFS for applications and workloads requiring shared read and write access across multiple EC2 instances, containers, or from multiple on-premises servers such as Steam file shares, highly available enterprise applications, analytics workloads, and ML training workloads. On the other hand, applications that require usage of SMB protocol can use FSX for Windows instead of EFS. With EFS, you don't have to worry about provisioning a certain size. So whether your application is 1 terabyte or 1 petabyte, EFS will automatically grow as your storage size increases. Finally, Amazon File Cache is a fully managed high-speed cache on AWS that is used to process file data, regardless of where that data is stored. It serves as a temporary, high-performance storage location for data that is stored in on-premises file systems, FSX, and S3 buckets. As the name indicates, you can use File Cache either standalone or in combination with other AWS storage offerings to offer better performance for very latency-sensitive workloads. General cache best practices also apply to Amazon File Cache. In this episode, we discuss the different storage options available in AWS and how you can correctly select the right storage offering based on your workload and usage patterns. I hope this provides guidance as you're launching and running your workloads. For more information, check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.